Now I will introduce some research in my laboratory. Oh, this is the outline. This is the background. Polyplants are usual in the natural world, and they are divided into autoploiploids and allopolyploids. Both of them are prevalent in the natural world, such as the important crop crops with, oilseed crop, cotton, they are all polyploids. Even some plants with a small genome, such as rice, is also ancient polyploids. Polyploid has played the important roles in plant evolution. Some researches we have found found some genome changes. These changes is called genome shock by McClintock. This including DNA sequence elimination, chromosomal rearrangements, transposon activation, DNA methylation. We also found some gene expression changes, including gene silencing activation, non-additive expression, and sub-functionalization and new functionalization. This also is called a transcriptopic shock. many plants are natural polyploids, but some plants, polyploids are synthesized by ourselves. The Brassica umbrella, this is important crop. Many of them are crop. Dr. Viswanesh has introduced this triangle. The species in the angle are diploid plants, and these plants are tetraploids by hybridization and the chromosomal doubling of these plants. Now I will introduce two of my research. One is transcriptopic changes in synthetic tree genomic allopolyploids of Brassica. The natural polyploids in Brassica are tetraploiploids, but in this research, we synthesized hexaploid. This is formed by the hybridization between Brassica ruralis diploid and Brassica carnata. This is tetraploiploids. By hybridization and chromosome doubling, we formed the hexaploids. This is our sequence flow chart, including sequencing and bioinformatics analysis. This is a saturation analysis of genes detected by sequencing reads. When the reads reached more than 10 million, the genes detected in this method is saturated. So the genes detected is suitable for the succeeded analysis. This is the number of seeds matched to Brassica rapa genome. This genome has finished the whole genome sequencing about 2 years ago, and we used this genome as a reference genome. We found that this is the mapped reads, more than 50 reads was matched to this genome, and the highest is in Brassica rapa. This number is 76. This is a different read coverage of genes in three libraries. The green part is the largest part, and these genes was covered by more than 90%. This is the genes expression in the Brassica hexaploid and its parents. A is Brassica rapa, this is carinata, this is hexaploid. In total, more than 32,000 genes was detected in this research, and more than 25,000 genes are shared by this species, and this number are specific for these three plants respectively. These are gene ontology annotations of all detected genes, or three kinds of ontology, including biological process, cellular components, and molecular functions. These genes are enriched in all of the sub kinds. These are differently expressed genes detected between Brassica hexploid and its parents. This is compared with Brassica rapa, the paternal parent, and this is compared with the Brassica carinata. We found different DEGs are in the comparison between Brassica hexploids and the Brassica rapa. This is the DEGs annotation. We found that most of the subkinds have DEGs, and most of the DEGs are in catalytic activity, binding, cell part and cell, and metabolic process, and cellular process. This is a hierarchical clustering. Red indicator upregulated genes, and green indicator downregulated genes. We also found some non-additive genes expressed in Brassica hexploid, and of these non-retentive genes, most of them are either between Brassica hexploid and Brassica rapa, or between Brassica hexploid and Brassica carinata. This is a annotation of non-additive genes. Three kinds and subkinds genes are all defined. We also found some transcription factor genes are DEGs. Differently expressed between Brassica hexploid and Brassica rapa, the number is 101 genes, with 49 genes upregulated and 52 genes downregulated in the hexploids. And the differential expressed genes between hexploid and Brassica carinata, the number is 76, with 46 genes upregulated and 30 downregulated. For example, is the TCP. This result was validated by quantitative real-time PCR. This is a summary of the gene expression. First, we found a large proportion of DEGs between hexploid and its parents was involved in biosynthesis of secondary metabolites, plant pathogen in autoregulation, photosynthesis, and plant hormone signal transduction. Second, there were big difference on the level of gene expression between hexploid and its paternal parent compared with its maternal parents. This variation may partly be affected by the cytoplasmic and the maternal effects. Finally, gene expression analysis showed that hexploid can generate extensive transcriptome diversity compared to its parents. These changes may contribute to the growth and the reproduction rates in this hexploid. The second part is the characterization and the expression patterns of small R genes in synthesis or Brassica hexploid. Or plant maturity is the same with the previous research. This is the sequence method, including sequencing and bioinformatics analysis. This is the length distribution and the category distribution of small RNAs. Most of the small RNA are in the length of 24 nucleotides. This is different kinds of RNA's distribution in these three plants. This is the distribution of small RNA classes in Brassica hexploid and its parents. This is microRNA. About 10% of the reads are microRNA. This is a diagram showing the known microRNAs expressed in these three plants. or this Brassica rapa, Brassica carnata, and the Brassica hexaploid, about 600 to 700 microns are detected in these three plants, and about 400 microns are shared by these three plants. This abundance of expression abundance of non microns in the three plants. Most of the microns is expressed in a low deep abundance, and 100 reads. Only 80 microns will high expressed, such as this 3 micron, this 5 micron. This is a different expression of non micron. The red indicator, the upregulated, the blue is equal expressed, and the low is and the green is low expressed. This result is also validated by quantitative real time PCR. We also integrated this microRNA analysis results with mRNA analysis results. The results suggested that target genes involved in response to stimulus are significantly enriched in coherent target genes of down-regulated microRNAs. This is this one response to stimulus in the comparison with Brassica rapa or Brassica carnata. Both of them are, most of the genes are response to stimulants. This is a distribution of non-additively expressed microns detected in the hexaploid. This is upregulated and this is downregulated. This is a gene ontology classification of target genes of additive and non-additive microRNAs. We also identified and qualitated of some potentially novel microRNAs. This is a number about 100 or more. This is a validation figures. This is a distribution of expressed, or most of them are expressed in low abundance. This is a summary of small RNAs expression. First, a total of 618 different expressed microns were detected between Brassica hexaploid and its parents. Second, more different expressed microns with a large difference in expression exists between Brassica hexaploid and Brassica rapa, which is consistent with the progenitor biased gene expression in this hexaploid. So the target genes involved in response to stimulus are significantly enriched in coherent target genes of down-regulated microRNAs. Generally, these results increase our understanding of the gene expression and regulation mechanism in Brassica polyploids. I want to express my thanks to Professor Jinling Meng, Huadong Agricultural University in China. He provided the plant materials, and Ms. Zhao and Ms. Shen finished the experiment. This work was supported by NSFC. Thanks.
Okay. All right, who has a question? Anybody has a question? Comment? Okay.
Perfect.
In your SmRNA analysis, you mentioned that your target,
target genes,
this only based on the prediction, or have you done degree down to the target?
I do this research by two methods. It's a production, by bioinformatics. We know the potential target genes of every micron is, on one hand, we by biometrics, bioinformatics analysis, and second, we have two databases, and we compare the database, and found that some potential target genes are actually regulated by micron. The number is about 25 a quarter.
Within these target genes, have you found some interesting transcription factors?
Yeah. We found about 700 transcriptional genes, and some of them are actually regulated by this microRNA.
Okay.
Yeah.
But
do
you have a rough number, a percentage?
It's also the same as the total microRNA is about 20 to 30 吧. Sorry.
Okay, I have a question.
Yeah.
You said that there are lots of non-additive genes and additive genes, and including microRNA.
MicroRNA and RNA.
Yeah. So are there any relationship between genes and microRNA?
Genes and microRNA is
additive genes and additive microRNA. And
Actually, some genes, we have this one. We do a correlated analysis between target genes and microRNA. The details, I could put a project for you. Yeah. Okay.
Just a short just a question that I just would like to hear your opinion about apomixis, in a sense that apomixis is related to higher ploidy, at least, excessive proportion of plants being wild and being apomictic are polyploid. So what do you think is the real explanation behind that? Is it really true that polyploidy is a bit of a prerequisite for apomixis to evolve, or the hybridization theories which you go for? So how do you envisage this?
This is a new synthesis, the polyploid. In natural, we only have tetraploid plants in Brassica. This hexaploid plus the hexaploid Brassica plants is synthesized by Professor Meng. The main goal is to improve the productivity and improve the ability to stress to abiotic or biotic stress. But now this material is not cultivated as a crop plants. It's in the process.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.